Hello, this is Trailer Talk for Tuesday. It's June 16th, 2015. This is our first episode, so this is going to turn out well. I'm Civvie, and I'm joined by...
Whoever wants to go first.
And this is Wallace.
All right, so now we got everybody. I'm going to explain how this works. A lot of trailers came out because it's E3 this week. So we're going to talk about how we feel about these trailers and these games. A lot of it's going to be off of just the trailers. Many of the things we might not have seen. I've seen all the press conferences, but I haven't been watching all the sideshow stuff. So there will be things that have happened on the sideshows, like on GameSpot or IGN, that I've not seen. So we're just going off of what's kind of in the trailer and what we know from other gaming sources. So it's not going to be complete, but this is what we feel about it. And I think everyone has seen less than me, definitely. How much have you guys been following it?
I went through a lot of it yesterday.
Just a lot of the trailers?
Yeah, just the trailers, really. I was watching a little bit of the stream stuff today, but
Parker?
Alright, I only really kind of looked into stuff that I was actually interested in, and then I looked over the rest of the trailers that you posted earlier.
Yeah, so I'm pretty much the only one who knows anything other than the trailers, which is fine. This is kind of what we want. It's kind of like a reactions sort of show, so sit back, stick it on a second monitor. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't expect you to just sit and watch this, because it's going to be just trailers running that you've probably already seen. And if you haven't seen them, I'm probably going to cut them a bunch so that they kind of match up with what we're talking about. Mm-hmm. So
you're going to put work into this.
Maybe.
You're not just gonna stick like a title card on it.
No, I don't even have a title card. It has a little glowy thing in the corner. You can't see it right now because it's probably already over.
Oh well.
I might make it run the whole video. I could do that. I have that power.
Don't abuse that power.
Yep, abuse it. That's how split screen is run. So we're gonna get right in this with we've got our first on the list. We're kind of doing this in chronological order. I kind of put these in order via press conferences and how they kind of came out. So we're doing Bethesda first, so that means Doom.
Yeah, Doom. Doom.
Doom.
I think this is mostly put on here for Wallace, so let's hear what Wallace thinks first.
I think, and I'm going to make this real short, I think Doom is super bland.
I agree.
Super duper bland.
Oh man, it's so brown.
I made the joke that it's like one of those games that they play on the TV of like a TV show that's talking about video games, or like one of those courses for online game development.
I think Doom 3's actually been used for that before.
I think it's been
CSI.
Yeah. Because that's exactly what that game looks like. It's like brown and it's just generic violence. From everything in that trailer.
I found the trailer really hard to follow.
And killing.
Oh yeah, the camera angles were getting pretty crazy. Because you like leap forward, it's kind of like a Halo punch system where you kind of magnet to the enemy when you melee attack them.
Yeah.
It was showing a lot of the stuff that like, hey, people, if you like Doom, these are things that you might like. But if you've never seen Doom before, if you've never played Doom, this is just generic ass shooter bullshit to you.
Yeah.
I like generic ass shooter bullshit, but I never played Doom, so it's just like,
this is what old people think all video games are like, is Doom. This new Doom.
Or anime games. Yeah.
That too.
I feel like I'm getting old when I looked at that, because like for a lot of it, I had a hard time actually following it since I've never really played a Doom game or planned to play a Doom game, and yeah, I actually had to like replay the last little bit of that trailer just to actually figure out what was happening in the last like couple of seconds. I was pretty sure he was getting his arm ripped off and then getting beaten with his own arm.
Yeah.
But I wasn't sure about it. So I had to watch that like 3 or 4 times just to make sure.
The funny thing about you feeling old is I think it's more pandering to the nostalgia of the old people who are supposed to be like grown up now and playing it.
You know, that's kind of the theme of E3 this year.
Yeah, with these other things we're going to talk about, it's a lot of that stuff.
There's a lot of blowing your nostalgia bone.
If that's how it's going to be, I mean, like, they're blowing your nostalgia bone with legit games this year by the looks of it, instead of like, hey, we brought this thing out on mobile, which is what Square was doing for a long time. We'll get to Square later, but
Square like, actually brought it.
Square was like, yo,
I'm impressed.
We don't speak English, but hey, check out these games that we have.
Yeah.
All right, so that was Doom.
Doom.
It's it needs more of The Rock, I think.
Yeah. I think so.
Just bring the people's elbow. In fact, that should be one of the melee attacks, is you just people's elbow people.
People's elbow. I would actually play Doom if that were true.
Yeah.
Because right now, I'm not interested.
Yeah. This is a flat line. If this is a morning show, I'd just be playing sound effects all the time.
Yeah. I'll be your soundboard.
Great.
Looking like my Audacity for the past couple of minutes here. Just a flat line for the most part.
It's going to be like that. Don't worry.
Don't worry. Here comes Fallout 4.
Yeah.
Now, who here is excited for Fallout 4? I think all of us?
A little bit.
You? Well, yeah, because you have, like, no enthusiasm whatsoever.
I've never also played a Fallout game, so...
Wait, really?
I played 40 minutes of New Vegas, and that's
part of your problem, dude. I mean, New Vegas is not the game you want to go into.
Yeah, that's about all the New Vegas I was able to run before I got incredibly bored and left.
Yeah.
I think I made like 4 or 5 hours, but I was probably streaming it.
I think so.
I bought it for the TF2 item.
Yeah, of course you did.
I think I did as well.
But anyway, Fallout 4.
Fallout 4.
Thoughts.
They are doing us a solid here, I think.
I think so.
With what they're doing, especially with the mod stuff on the console side, that stuff is bananas.
Yeah.
If you didn't know, they are bringing... They said they'll let you bring any mod. What they probably actually mean is they'll let you bring any mod that is totally okay with them. So they won't let you have, you know... In Fallout 3, a lot of people were playing with the Lightning Returns character and stuff like that. They're not going to let you do that, obviously, on a console, because they don't want to get sued.
I'm sure they'll have their own portal that you can download mods through that will be approved by probably
both. Or it'll
be
the workshop that you can only download mods through.
Yeah,
and
something like that.
They'll get it on the workshop. But, like, the other things that they're doing, which is the customization of, like, a base... For you to kind of build, sort of Rust style.
Yeah, that sounds super interesting.
That sounds cool, but I see it being super cool for mods, but the way they're going to put it in the game is going to be super lame. Yeah. So, like, they're going to have, like, really lame parts, and you're not going to be able to build, like, your crazy fuck cabin in the middle of nowhere. Whereas the mod scene is going to be like, yo, you want to build, like, the fucking Washington Monument, son? Let's do it. Like... The mod shit for that's going to be bananas.
Yeah.
Part of the problem, I think, for the normal stuff is going to be that you can't show it to anyone. Like, part of that building game genre is all about,
showing it off.
We in Bontracorp, which is our Minecraft, fake Minecraft thing,
we pride ourselves in
having a building that's cooler than everyone else's on the server at the time.
Yep.
So, like, that's part of the whole building thing, is you have this bananas building, and everyone's like, oh my god, your building is so cool, mm-hmm. and we're like, yeah, you want to see our fucking sign turn off and on? What?
Also, our doors have doorbells on them.
Yeah,
you
see,
walk over
this
and
is,
it goes, ding dong.
These are cool things that would be awesome in multiplayer environment. They need to figure out multiplayer and Fallout.
Co-op
multiplayer.
And Fallout.
Yeah, oh man, Bethesda game with co-op. Be so good. Touch
that would be.
Penis, please.
I don't know. Well, okay.
Yeah. Parker, anyway. How do you feel about this?
I basically just echo your guys' things on there. It's obviously going to be different when you actually get your hands on it, but for some reason, the combat in the game reminded me of Borderlands a bit, so I don't know about
really?
That one.
It just reminded me of Fallout.
No, you can actually hit things with guns now.
Oh, you can?
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Ooh.
See?
Actually,
everything's changed.
I wanted to bring up the point that some people I hear complaining about is how it looks. Like, some people are complaining that it doesn't look next-gen enough. I was gonna
forget is that they forget the last time they saw a Fallout game or an Elder Scrolls game, they saw it with E&B on, which is very, very, very different than what the game ships with. Every Elder Scrolls game every Fallout game looks like fucking balls.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to get that out there, that the game looks terrible. The things they're doing in Fallout 4 with the lighting is stuff you simply cannot do in Fallout 3. The lighting system does not work that way.
Yeah.
It's not a huge graphical, like, oh my god, look at this Final Fantasy, crazy zippers everywhere. Like, you can't do that with that kind of game, just because of how big it is. You're not gonna be able to fit it on a disc if you want to do that sort of overproduction. But, like, the things they've changed to make it better, make it look a lot better. You need to go back and look at what those games look like before someone mods the shit out of them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I'd like to put in, it's because of you that we have these sorts of game problems with games being and looking really nice and then being real shit.
I'm sorry that I ran 150 mods on my stream.
It was over 200 at one point, man.
Yeah.
And then it crashed.
Yeah. Then I had to restart.
You had to reinstall your fucking game because you broke it.
That's what happens, man. Mods are some shit. Another cool thing that they're doing in Fallout, I don't know if this is in the trailer, is that they're letting you customize your guns.
Yeah, that was there. It was also there with the power armor as well.
How much are they letting you customize?
Every part comes off. It's different barrels, different, what is that part called? If you replicate it, it becomes a gun. The part with the trigger on it. That part.
Okay, that part.
And they let you have stocks and they let you have scopes.
Huh.
That's another part that's going to be super cool with mods.
Yeah.
What like about the jetpacks?
We're not to the mech stuff yet.
We're not? Oh.
No. Can you hear my penis hitting the table? We're not to the mech part yet.
Can you hear it busting through his table right now?
Yep. We can skip to the mech part, though, if you'd like.
That's fine, if you want.
All right. So let's go to... We're going to talk about the power armor part. So it appears that you are going to get your own power armor, and you're going to get to, like... It's not going to be like Fallout 3, where you, like, just wear it like armor. It's going to be like...
It's its own thing.
Yeah, it's going to be more like Lost Planet, where you, like, jump in the armor, and then you fuck shit up.
It's an actual suit of armor that you have separate from whatever you're wearing, I guess.
Yeah, like a vehicle. Maybe with that armor system, they'll actually put vehicles back in the game.
Man, that'd be cool.
Yeah. Can I lay down in the vehicle and get the same shot precision as I would be normally driving or laying down, but be able to drive the vehicle at the same time?
No.
That's something you can do in Fallout Tactics, and it's hilarious. But yeah, that whole part, them putting a jetpack on it is a huge thing. That's another, like, next-gen feature that they could not do in old Fallout.
Yeah.
If they put a jetpack on it, that means they actually finished most of the buildings. In old Fallout, the buildings were...
Yeah, they were just facades.
Yeah.
There wasn't an actual top to it.
That means they've actually put roofs or at least rubble in there that you won't fall through.
They're fully modeled for once.
Well, you know, my Type C bodies are always...
Yeah. Alright. Yeah. Anything else about Fallout you want to talk about?
There's a dog?
Yeah, I was going to bring up the dog. I don't really care about the dog.
I never use the dog.
I don't know why they keep bringing up the dog. The dog's not important.
People really like animals.
I don't
like.
Yeah, but I never use the dog in any Fallout game.
I've had the dog, but it always dies really easily.
Actually, no. In New Vegas, I used the dog. Because there was a robot dog that had a human brain, and it would talk.
Yes. Yes, I remember that dog. I think I had that dog in my party for a while.
That dog was cool.
They need to let you have a bigger party.
Yeah.
I mean, a dog and another person is kind of a lot in the wasteland, but let me have more people.
Nah.
Let me have a mech squad.
Crew. Yeah.
And it appears you can call vertibirds, which is super cool.
I was going to say, yeah, you can fly around in one and actually tell it where to land.
And importantly, they showed, I believe that blimp is the Brotherhood blimp that they fly around in and spread the Brotherhood across America.
Spread the Brotherhood.
Spread Brotherhood. Which is what you did in Tactics.
Yeah.
which is super cool. I like super to see more cool tech stuff. Fallout 3 was severely lacking in it until you got to the Enclave parts, and then you did that one part and the whole rest of the game has like zero cool tech in it, which I guess, you know, is kind of part of the course. But I'd like to see more power armors. Oh, I can't wait for the Gundam mod for that power armor thing. Yeah, mm-hmm. Rolling like a...
You're just thinking about potential now.
Yeah.
I guess that's a good thing about a game like Fallout. It sparks your imagination, especially with modding.
Yeah. Unfortunately, they're probably going to bring out paid mods and ruin the whole thing.
Probably.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Except that the Nexus has promised never to put paid mods on their service.
Yeah,
so
but Steam
unless
will.
They lock down the mods, which they can't do.
Yeah.
They can try. They can try.
Seems pretty dumb to try.
Yeah. That's a different trailer talk, I think.
Yeah, that's a completely different podcasty thing we can do.
Yeah. Okay, so we're going off Fallout and going straight into Dishonored, which...
Yeah.
I know you
have never really liked Dishonored, like you've never been interested in it.
Yeah.
But I was a pretty big fan of the first one, especially when it came out, and then I played through it and it was like it's an okay game. It's all right. It had some cool parts. I like the stealth in Dishonored. And I wasn't going to bring up Dishonored 2 on the list. Except that you get to play as the girl who was the Empress in the first game. She becomes this badass assassin, apparently.
Makes sense. She hangs out with the assassin guys.
Yeah, she hangs out with the assassin guys. So, something about that trailer kind of just made me excited for it. Like, the way it looks. I don't know if that's, what's the name of the place in Dishonored? Dunkirk? Something like that?
Yeah,
I don't know
like that.
If that is the same place. I don't think it is, or it might be, but just the I always liked the way Dishonored looked. I like the art style of it, and the tone of that trailer, the way it played out, the evil guy's monologue. I just like there are parts of that trailer that make me really excited for it. Even though when I finished Dishonored 1, I was like, yeah, that's okay. If they actually do make a sequel, I'll probably play it. But now I'm a little hyped for it. I'm just a little bit hype. Which is why I wanted to talk about it.
I'm just waiting for the speedruns. That seems to be the only Dishonored I ever watched.
Yeah, there's probably going to be a speedrun. And then that'll be it. But hey.
I thought there was like a decent... the only speed the things I've watched of Dishonored 1 was speedruns like Alex, so...
Yeah.
I've only watched Cerno speedruns of it.
I'm the only one who actually cared about it in any, like, big way.
So, like... Doesn't it kind of, like, downplay the first games? I'm assuming the first game had, like, an actual decent ending to just suddenly have another sequel on.
It had multiple endings, is the thing.
Yeah.
So I don't know how they reconcile that. I'm fairly certain they just pick an ending. I don't really remember what all the endings were, either. So I'm just assuming that they picked one and said, this is canon, and we're starting off from there. Because I think one of the endings, she dies.
Yeah.
Like the Empress, the Emily, the one that's in the trailer. I think she dies at some point. But, yeah, that's obviously moot. For Dishonored 2.
I feel like the game probably should have taken place like a couple of generations later.
It probably should have taken place in a completely different place. Like a completely different era or something, but... I think if they're going to stick with the style and try and continue whatever story there was in Dishonored, they had to have some characters return for context.
I guess. That's all I had to say about it.
Yeah, that's pretty much all I got for Dishonored. So if you want to move on.
All right. So we're going to move on to something that constantly makes us yawn, Halo 5.
Oh, look. It doesn't make me yawn constantly.
only whenever it's on the screen.
Only whenever I... Okay, here's what I don't like about Halo 5. Not the game itself, but how it was presented at the press conference. When the screens popped up and there were just four people standing there on the stage with controllers. I hate that. I hate that press conference.
Like, hey, yo, it's a live demo.
It's not a live demo. That was obviously not a live demo. Quit trying to play that ruse of like, oh, we're playing this game. No, you're not. You're just standing there like a dumbass with a controller. Because seriously, like in that demo, the dude that's on the main screen that you see from his perspective is like giving orders to these people and they're following it. It's like, well, that's obviously not a fucking co-op game then.
Oh, you know what was really cool about that though? He Republic Commander pointed at something.
He did.
To mark it. That was super
cool.
That
is a plus one.
I think that sounds extremely useful.
That sounds cool.
For stuff, especially if everyone can mark stuff like different colors.
Yeah.
So then you can all pick different targets, and it's not whoever snipes the guy first.
Yeah.
Because we've ran into that where it's like, okay, I'm gonna kill this guy, and you're like, okay, I'm gonna kill the other guy, and we were both talking about the same guy.
Yeah.
Now legendary run gets fucked.
Oh, let's not talk about Vidmaster, please. I don't want to talk about Vidmaster. Can we talk about Buck instead?
Yeah, let's talk about Buck. Buck is back. About Buck. He's ready to...
Is Buck a Spartan? I need to make it official.
Assume...
Is he a Spartan now?
Well, I don't know.
Because he's in Spartan armor.
Well, you know, everybody's got to have power armor.
Well,
but I don't know about the Spartan fours or fives or whatever
like
they are.
The other three are Spartans. Is he a Spartan? Yeah.
Maybe he's with Oni, and he's got some crazy Oni power armor.
Maybe. I don't know.
Who knows?
But yeah, more Nathan Fillion, so.
Yeah, more. We've got everyone we need. There was the Arbiter.
Arbiter's there.
No Half-Jaw yet. If Half-Jaw's in there, I think Half-Jaw has to be on Master Chief's team.
I assume so.
That'd be fucked.
See, I never played Halo 4.
Me
so
either.
I
watched the cutscenes.
I have no idea what happens in that game.
Okay, here we go. I'm going to tell you what Halo 4
is. Do we want to spend the time in this to actually explain
it?
I'm going
to tell you what Halo 4 is. Okay, so Master Chief is in space.
Yeah.
At the end of Halo 3, right?
Yes.
He gets cut off.
I remember.
And then his spaceship gets sucked into a giant ball.
Yeah, I remember that part too.
Okay. And then he lands on the ball and then finds out that there's other Covenant and shit going on in the ball.
Okay.
Which is a lot like a Halo.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna say.
Is it a Dyson sphere from like the
it
books?
It is. Yes, I think so.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure it's a Dyson sphere. Okay. So he lands in the ball, and then there was a group of humans who have come out looking for whatever, touching themselves, who cares?
Yeah.
Probably looking for Halo rings, I would assume. Since
of
they're
course.
Full of Spartans, I would assume that there's Halo rings that they're looking for.
They're always looking for Halo rings in Halo.
And then Cortana is dying because of the 7-year rule.
Yeah, she's
AI
crazy.
Yeah. So he's going around like trying to deny that she's dying. And then he meets some giant ball Forerunner thing because the Forerunners are still alive. Pro tip.
Awesome.
Yeah. And then he takes with the humans. They escape. And then at the end, if you beat it on super hard, you get to see Master Chief's face. He's very white.
You actually get to see his face?
Yes.
Oh shit,
which
how
is
did
a
I
terrible
not know
move.
About this?
Because you only get it if you beat it on the super hardest.
Oh man. Oh well.
That's what all that happens.
So that's Halo
There's
5.
There's Didact shit? I don't know. Like,
whatever.
I think Halo got too far up its own ass.
Of course.
Which is why Halo 5 is like,
no,
I mean, Halo plays really fucking well.
There are parts of that Halo 5 trailer that made me a little excited for it.
Yeah.
But I don't want to buy an Xbox One.
No.
I don't.
It's the same reason that I'm super hyped for the Master Chief Collection. They just have to bring it to Windows 10.
They have to bring it to PC. Or no purchase. Sorry.
Bring it to PC, sell it for $100, I'll buy that shit. I don't give a fuck.
Oh yeah. That's well worth $100.
Yeah.
Have all the Halo games.
Especially with ODST in it. They just added ODST. HD ODST.
Oh, that'd be so good.
Touch my penis.
Oh, my penis.
I will say something about Halo 4. They have mechs, so that's cool.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Yeah.
So, Recore. Speaking of mechs.
Oh, yeah.
Recore is a game about robots.
Recore is a game about your robot friends.
And it appeared out of fucking nowhere in
and
the press conference.
And it's Keiji Inafune, apparently.
Yeah.
So, great.
Your robots have a core.
It's Dead Rising. I don't know. Are there zombies in it? Are they zombie robots?
I think they're evil robots.
Yeah, but they're good robots, because you got that
The blue ones are good robots.
You got the fortune teller's ball, and you put it in the robot, and the robot's your friend, and it helps you. And then
the red robots are mean.
You say, good job, buddy, and that's it, right?
Yeah, that's
you
what
solve
all
puzzles.
That said about that. Apparently, I was watching a little bit of the Twitch TV broadcast brought to you by Man vs. Game.
Man vs. Game.
Actually, it was kind of cool to see Man on stage.
That's fine.
Speaking to the developer in classical Nihongo. Well, he wasn't speaking it, but he was understanding it. He was all doing right. The uh-huh, yeah, uh-huh. The constant, like, yeah, I know what you're talking about, but I have to wait uh-huh. for this shit to finish.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So apparently it's an action-adventure game.
Yeah, I assume so.
Where you solve, like, puzzles and shit.
Yeah.
That sounds like get super more friends. Generic.
That's exactly what I took away from that trailer, yeah.
Yeah. It looked cool.
No robots.
It's exploding dogs.
Not pilotable robots. Yeah, exploding dogs is good. They should put that in Fallout. Moving on to Cuphead.
I don't know why you brought this up. That's an indie game. You hate indie games.
I fucking hate the way that game looks.
Oh,
that's
okay,
why
good.
It's on the list.
I was wondering why you put it on here. So like, there's no way you could have liked this game.
I love animation. I'm gonna tell you what. I fucking love animation.
You hate Cuphead, though.
You know what I fucking hate?
Indie games.
Old animation.
Oh. Really?
I fucking hate old animation.
You hate, like,
so
the
much.
Old Disney animation?
No, I hate that shit.
Oh, man.
So much. It's the worst level in Kingdom Hearts.
But it looks exactly like an old 30s animation.
The art direction in that game is fucking great.
Yeah.
Like, what they're doing is... I don't know how they're doing it. And I don't want to know. Because I hate that art style. But... Like, it looks exactly like they said it did. I mean, maybe it just plays in a trailer really well and doesn't actually look that good as the game, because it's an indie game. So it's going to be fucking garbage. What? But, like, they brought that up on stage and it was like, wow, this is actually, like, super cool.
Yay.
Except for the fact that it looks like a 1930s cartoon, which is really dumb. But hey, if that's what you like, that's what you like. And do what you like.
Like what you do.
Yeah. So, yeah. I assume no one else has anything to say about that. I just wanted to say that I didn't like it.
I was just questioning why you put it there, and that's all I had.
Perfect. Yeah. We're going to go on to Rare Replay.
Oh, man.
Which looks...
Oh, man.
See, I told you it was on there for Wallace Parker.
Oh, my God.
Kidding.
You get... Oh, my God.
I can hear Wallace's penis right now.
Oh,
you do get nuts and bolts, so I'm fucking hyped. $30 for nuts and bolts is a great price.
Well, you not only get nuts and bolts, you get Banjo 1 and 2, but also, for me, you get both Viva Pinatas.
Oh, yeah, it's true.
You get Viva Pinata, and then Trouble in Paradise, you get Conker's Bad Fur Day, you get fucking Perfect Dark, Battletoads for people who actually give a shit about Battletoads. You get, oh, shit. What
25
other
games?
Yeah, you get a whole bunch of other ones for $30.
Yeah, $30 is a fucking great price.
See, that I would buy an Xbox One. That tempted
me. That's a console move
there. I'm like,
they should put that.
Ooh.
In fact, they should put that in the box. That
should
be there in the box.
If they don't have a bundle for that, whenever is that coming out this holiday?
I think so.
If they don't bundle that this holiday, they're idiots.
Imagine if they put that in the box, just like, hey. By the way, when you buy an Xbox, you get 30 fucking games.
30 rare games. Those are good games.
Rare pantsu games.
Oh, my pantsu are gone right now.
Shit. They're so wet, they slipped off.
They dissolved.
Oh, man.
My pants are dissolved.
You should get that checked.
Oh. Anyway.
You need a sensei to check that out.
Whew, getting hot over here. Okay.
Yeah, I don't care about any rare game except for Nuts and Bolts, really. And maybe GoldenEye.
Yeah, GoldenEye.
If they could get GoldenEye, that'd be really fucking sweet.
Yeah,
but Nintendo's not letting that shit go.
No, they'll never do that.
Not only is Nintendo not letting that shit go, getting the rights to that shit, getting the James Bond rights must be ridiculous.
Yeah.
And not worth it for a $30 game.
No.
Whereas right now, all they had to do was port it.
Not if you're
like,
paying...
Okay, done.
Yeah, not if it's like you pay... pretty much a dollar for it. It's like, no, it's not gonna happen.
Yeah. with the Rare Replay thing, this isn't in the trailer, but it's something to talk about. They're bringing Xbox 360 games to the Xbox One.
Oh, yeah.
Which apparently is not emulation, which is unfortunate, because I want to see somebody take that code and make a PC emulator.
Yeah, that would be nice. Then I could play Viva Piñata all day, every day.
Yeah, you play it in a window all the time.
Yeah. Ooh, horstachios. Oh, so many horstachios. Make them sexy time.
Make them dance.
Oh, baby horstachios. Okay.
Whew. Parker, do you have any feelings about these games?
Not really, because when I had an N64, which is what a lot of those games were for, I was too heavy into Pokemon, so...
You just played Pokemon Stadium?
And Pokemon Snap, and Hey You Pikachu.
Man, that's a dark hole.
That is. Man.
It is a dark hole.
I lost all the cards on my monster side when you played that, man.
Yep, that's what Yu-Gi-Oh! Does to a man. That's why you play Magic the Gathering.
Alright. After Rare, they were like, yo, by the way, Gears 4, son.
Yeah, by the way, Gears of War still exists.
Put the do-rag back on.
Get you.
Except
no, nobody
they
was
didn't
wearing...
bother to show any Marcus Fenix.
Well, yeah, because I don't know exactly when that trailer is set. Also, none of them are wearing do-rags.
Unfortunate. In the Sizzle trailer... The sizzle for the start of the thing, they had Marcus put the thing back on, his D-Rag back on. So apparently he's probably going to be in the game.
Yeah.
A lot of people were complaining that trailer is really fucking dark.
Yeah, it is.
I don't recall it being that dark.
I was just confused as to what the hell was going on.
Apparently it was showing, apparently the original planet only has one moon. And this planet
and
has
two moons,
so they're not on Sarah.
They're no
I think
longer
is the name.
On Sarah. Huh? How'd that happen?
Well, they've always been a space race.
Oh.
I mean, like Sarah was like not Earth.
See, I don't.
And
I don't really
they're
know.
They're Earthlings.
Yeah, I don't know
the cogs
the lore
are space
of Gears.
Yeah, they're not from that place.
I always thought it was just like some alternate thing where. They were
no,
on
I'm pretty sure
planet.
They came to that planet for the juice, like Lost Planet.
For the emulsion.
Every game is Lost Planet.
Every game is Lost Planet. Every game can be boiled down to Lost Planet.
Every game can be boiled down to, look at all that juice!
Look at all that juice!
Gotta kill the over G.
That's an in-joke.
If only we had that recorded.
If only, well, we did, but then it disappeared.
Died. It wasn't in a good
no,
form.
No, it wasn't.
So... Parker never... we only made him buy an Xbox very late in the game and then never played it with him, so he doesn't have any feelings for Gears.
Yeah.
Those people looked actually moderately proportioned.
Yeah, that was also very weird.
Yeah, they're not super steroids.
Well, the in Gears 3, a lot of the characters who were not from the original thing were not super steroid dudes. I mean, the Coltrane is obviously super steroid because...
Yeah, but he played Blitzball or whatever.
Yeah. He did not play Blitzball.
I forgot what the name of that.
Maybe he did. Maybe that's how he got so ripped.
I don't remember what's the name of the sport in that.
I don't remember.
Yeah, see, I just thought it was Blitzball.
I'm pretty sure Blitzball turns you into, like...
It turns you into a Final Fantasy character.
Yeah.
Makes you wear zippered pants.
And look like a girl.
Yeah.
This is my story.
Both of those things.
Also, they announced with Gears 3... Or Gears 4, sorry.
Yeah.
That they're re-releasing... Or they're remaking Gears 1 in HD, which is pretty cool, except not on the PC. So
Gears 1 was already in HD.
They're gonna 60 frames per second.
They're gonna
1080
that bitch? Okay.
And I assume that means they're making it work for new netcode, so that you don't have a crazy host advantage. Because remember, that game died in multiplayer because you had like a couple second host advantage.
Yeah, I remember.
So, like, oh, you want to shoot the host? You can't! Lol. He just crab walked around you. Wrecked. Chainsaw.
Chainsaw in your ass.
Here's one that Parker can actually say something about.
Yeah, this is the Parker segment of the podcast.
We take a quick break for Parker.
Here's your quick break from our joking for Parker to talk about Dark Souls 3.
If it doesn't get a PC release, I don't care. That's all.
It's going to get a PC release.
Of course
release.
It is.
How do you feel
It's not
about...
Bloodborne. Like, it's Dark Souls. They're going to release it on everything.
eventually.
Yeah. And then they'll re-release it and charge you the same price.
No, they'll re-release it with the DLC and charge you $10, which is fine by me. So far, their DLC strategies have been pretty good.
I don't really have anything to say about Dark Souls 3 because that trailer told you fuck all, so...
There's fucking giants, man!
There's a giant guy with a hole for his face.
That's just the normal giants. They have hole
but
faces,
that's,
I don't know why.
He has a hole in his face.
There's
yeah,
nothing,
that's
how
giants
there's
face go.
New.
He's that's just giants.
But
there's nothing new there.
There's
and
no
also
prerequisite
tell you
for giants to not have faces.
Yeah, there is. In Dark Souls 2, they did not have faces.
Why don't they have faces?
I don't know. They're giants.
Fine.
They invaded.
I don't understand
maybe we're
that
going,
universe.
Maybe we're going back to the land where the giants live from that invaded in Dark Souls 2.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe that's what we're doing. Like, I know we're probably going to be an honored undead. What if we were a giant? What if that game was just you as a giant?
That you were that giant at the end?
You were the giant.
Oh, man. That game would be real short, I think.
That game probably wouldn't be called Dark Souls.
You're a glass giant. You die so easily.
Mm.
But you're also very large.
Still wouldn't be a Dark Souls game.
What if you were the giant, and in Giant Land, everything's bigger than you?
So it'd just be a game where...
You are a giant, but... The rest of the world is giganticer, so you're just normal size.
I guess that's a twist.
That would be pretty fucking cool. All I need is more Ultra Great Swords. Make them actually have durability this time, please.
Let's fix the 60 frames per second glitch. Thanks.
Well, you know. So yeah, Dark Souls. That shit, that trailer showed nothing.
Yep.
But Man vs. Game said it was pretty good, and except I trust him to know about Dark Souls because he plays it for infinity amount of hours.
There is one thing to take away.
What is it?
2016.
2016 for most of these games, in fact, yes. Halo 5 is this winter.
But that could be 2016 December.
Yeah.
At that point. And that's at that point, that's like saying, oh yeah, it's coming out eventually.
Yeah. That's how, but that's E3 in general.
Pretty much.
That's just how it is.
Can't be hype about any of it.
Yeah, but you're never
you gotta
hype
get your hype ready.
Come on, man. This is your game. You have to be hype about it.
When they show gameplay, I think that's when he'll get wet.
Yeah.
There's no gameplay. I can't. What am I supposed to take
that's
away
true.
From that?
Like
that's
it's hard. It's hard to get excited for a CG trailer anymore.
We'll definitely do another trailer talk at TGS 2015.
It'll probably...
Where they will probably show Dark Souls gameplay because it's Japan.
Yep.
Oh, wait, there was one thing to note. That stupid fountain they had. That you
that fountain that gushes blood, that's pretty sweet.
Yeah.
That's not in the trailer.
You need to put in a clip of that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did I link that in the Skype chat?
Yes, you
so
did.
I can...
Yeah.
Okay, good. Let's see. After Dark Souls, another thing that I don't think any of us care about, Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain.
Yeah, the only thing I can take away from the Metal Gear Solid 5 trailer is it's
Lion
like a
Flint, terribly. I don't speak French.
Oh, L'Enfant Terrible.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
Ha ha, he's French.
But it's we'll mostly just... It reminded me of the debacle with Kojima and Konami.
Yeah, Konami is
like,
on fucking fire.
Like
I think they planned it that way though, so it's okay.
I don't really care about Metal Gear Solid 5. All I'm thinking is just like, that's the last trailer that he's ever gonna make for them. Like this was Kojima's last Metal Gear trailer, I think.
And then he'll go to Kickstarter
and
make
$1 million. Make some other thing that's going to be like Metal Gear on Kickstarter and make millions.
But that game had a lot of shit if you don't know what's going on. Metal Gear,
I have no idea. I have no clue what Metal Gear is, what happens in it.
It's about the memes.
Yeah.
If you take away someone's, what they speak, you take away the person.
Something like that. There's a guy that's been burned, apparently. I don't know. He turns into Zorro at one point.
You should get that thing in his head checked out.
Yeah, he's... no, that's the big boss. He's talking about Skullface.
Yeah.
Skullface was apparently a bad guy in the little mini-game they brought out. What was that called? Ground Zeroes?
Yeah.
So, I don't know what's going on with that.
Eh.
It's Metal Gear.
Yeah,
Otacon's there.
Yeah, his life is being threatened. He looks like he's about to cry, as always.
Yeah, but this is way back in the day, so Revolver Ocelot is a young man.
Yeah,
revolving and ocelotting.
He's an ocelot that revolves.
You should see Metal Gear Solid 3 if you want to see how Ocelot is ocelotting. It's really funny.
We really have nothing else to say on this, do we? Like, there's nothing we care about with Metal Gear.
At the end, they showed two young blonde boys, which is probably Snake and Liquid.
I've played a little bit of Ground Zeroes. They were in that. I don't remember why they're in there.
Because they are?
Yeah.
Where's Solidus? Where's the president?
I don't know.
Find the president.
Where's the Metal Gear? They didn't show a Metal Gear.
They showed a Metal Gear.
Did they?
The little guy was driving Metal Gear.
I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah.
That's how much I care about Metal Gear.
There's a girl who needs to wear more clothes. It's the desert.
She teleports, or she like runs really fast, apparently.
She's a ninja. Maybe that's why she doesn't wear clothes.
Yeah.
Naked ninja.
Semi-nude ninjas. Only Kojima. But not anymore.
Yeah, because he's gone.
He's gone now.
You know what really sucks? That Metal Gear is dying. No more Revengeance.
No, there'll be more Revengeance.
I don't know about that.
Sure there will. Just not...
Platinum is doing some other stuff.
Okay, yeah, that's true. Platinum's got like three other games they're making now. But...
Yeah.
America is a
country of... Alright, so anyway. Let's jump to another universe.
To a completely different galaxy.
Yes.
Through a Mass Effect relay.
Oh, man.
So they're not saying anything about how the humans got there.
No.
Because the story part is probably lame, because they can't write a story to save their fucking lives after Mass Effect 1.
Well, dude, that's cold. But also, apparently...
I'm a straight-up gangster.
The ending of Mass Effect 3 was so hard to reconcile that they had to put the new one in a completely different galaxy.
Also, Wallace, how long into the trailer... Oh, I guess you already knew. How long into the trailer did it take you to recognize the N7 armor?
Pretty much right away.
It was fucking instant.
Yeah.
You know why it was instant for me? Because I fucking, like, I know the back of that helmet.
Yeah.
I saw the back of the helmet, I'm like, oh, that's N7 armor.
Yeah, this is a Mass Effect trailer.
Yeah, Mass Effect. There's great stars.
I only played Mass Effect 2, therefore I didn't recognize until I seen the N7.
That's what most people, I think, recognized it at, but I was like, you know what they should have been playing in that? Just really quietly? The New Worlds theme.
Yeah, the...
Yeah.
That would have been great.
That would have been fucking great.
Instead they played some Johnny Cash, I think.
Yeah. It's supposed to be all like, oh, now it's like the Wild West.
Yeah, we're like space truckers.
Hey, do you like that game?
Do you like old music and also space magic?
Do you like that game or that movie show?
Hey, remember
Serenity?
Yeah.
That one.
You mean Firefly?
There we go.
Yeah.
You know what? I don't really like Firefly.
Obviously.
This video is now getting downvotes.
Yeah, this video is gonna get so many downvotes now. They're gonna hate you. They're gonna unsubscribe. They'll subscribe.
That's fine,
and then
as long
unsubscribe.
As they watch the video.
No.
Watch the ads. I don't care.
Yeah. Whatever. But yeah, what else happened in that trailer? He stabs a dude with his...
There's the Mako.
Right, there's a new Mako.
You know what I like? The Mako.
Yeah.
I'm not even lying there. I actually like the Mako. The Mako made the world in Mass Effect way better.
Yeah. Problem with that trailer is it didn't show anything. So I can't really talk about it.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know anything about that game other than it's in the Andromeda Galaxy, apparently.
You know, instead of going there, they should have just waited.
Yeah.
If you wait long enough, Andromeda Galaxy comes to you.
It's coming to you, baby, in like 100 billion years or whatever.
Yeah. I mean, like, you got time. You got Mass Effect relays.
All we got is time.
Yeah, you killed the dudes. You
killed all the Reapers.
Yeah.
Or you made the Reapers your friend. Spoilers.
Or you became the Reapers.
That's true.
I went with the friend.
Or you became creepy, like, translucent cyber people.
That's what I mean, yeah. I personally went with the make the Reapers your buddies, and then my personal backcanon was then you went around policing the galaxy with your sweet Reaper buddy cop, Garrus.
Garrus. Your buddy cop team. I would, yeah. I'd be okay with that ending.
See, this is a great...
That's a better ending.
We need to have a... I need to make a video just about the Mass Effect ending I want to see.
You know, yeah. If that game didn't come out so long ago, we should have done something about that.
I should do it anyway.
Yeah, maybe. All right, that's enough Mass Effect.
Okay, how do you feel about Affront?
Affront?
Of battling.
I was affronted by it. No.
How do you feel about a Star Wars Battlefront?
I like it. It looks cool. Yeah. It looks really cool.
Can't wait for them to fuck it up.
It's an EA game, though.
Would you like to connect to our servers?
It's a game.
Do you use Firefox?
Yeah, it's a game made by DICE, but published by EA. So
the servers will be bullshit.
It's gonna be browser based. Yay! Browser based gaming. That's the future.
Yeah, that looks really unfinished. It does not look finished.
No, it's clearly not finished, but it looks cool.
It looks cool. I think it might be the maps might be too dense with what they were showing. I know they were skipping all the boring parts of the maps, but if you have like a super dense map and you're trying to make it feel really big, it's hard to make it feel big when it's just like a bunch of little fights all over the place.
Yeah, just everything just looks very smooth.
Yes.
Everything, all the animation, explosions, it just all looks really smooth.
They spent a lot of money.
They spent a lot of money on it. And it looks nice. I don't know if I will play it for any extended period of time. I don't even really like Star Wars that much, but
I do like, I've played
that game looks
many
fun.
Hours of Battlefront.
Yeah.
Parker, how do you feel about Battlefront?
I won't play that one, but I like Battlefront that was out before.
Why don't you like this one?
I don't know. It seemed like super scripted, so I'd actually like to see how the actual gameplay is when real people play it, not a bunch of scripted bullshit, because...
A lot of you being sniped.
It'll play a lot like Battlefield.
Yeah, it looks like it's just going to be...
It's a Battlefield reskin. So...
Yeah, because, like, it was like, oh, this is taken from a real multiplayer game, and then they, like, go crouch by the one thing. I'm like, yeah, that's not a real multiplayer game. Nice try. Yeah.
They stand near a vehicle for more than 3 seconds without it either exploding or being ran into.
Yeah, because in the beginning, like, there's... I don't know which trailer you link to. Oh, the Hoth level? Yeah, because in the Hoth level, like, at the very beginning, they're all standing in front of that door. I was like, that's not actually going to happen.
Also, your PC cannot render that HDR effect that they use.
No, but it would be awesome if it did.
I'm just going to say, do you have 3 Titans?
No.
No? Then you can't!
No, unfortunately.
Because the lighting effect on that, unless it's a static lighting effect, which would look really bad when you walk through it, which would just... It'd basically be a fog door in Dark Souls if they wanted to make that like that. Like, your PC cannot run what that game looks like, and the console will look nothing like that.
That's true.
Get ready for a downgrade, because it's gonna be.
That game looks too good for console specs, unfortunately. Yeah.
That's just how it is. If you're a console gamer, so you should get used to that.
Gotta deal with it.
If you're a PC gamer, you have to get used to that right away, because you put in your new graphics card and you're like, I'm gonna turn everything up to high.
Nope.
And then it's like, nah.
Already outdated. Get a new one.
It's like, PSO, you want to run that at max? Nah.
Nope. Sorry.
Nah, this game plays on a Vita. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
I want that game to be good, but I can't. Don't know if I can trust them to make a game that actually works.
I can't. I can't trust EA with that kind of thing.
Also, they call it an orbital strike. It's an orbital bombardment. Get your naval terms properly.
Now you're just being nitpicky. Seriously.
I am, yeah. It's fucking Star Wars. People are going to be nitpicky. If you make Luke use his lightsaber in the wrong hand, people are going to fucking flip their shit.
Did he use it in the wrong hand?
No, I don't know.
I don't know.
I was referencing Legend of Zelda.
But now that I think about it.
The first one that came out for the Wii, where they had
Twilight Princess.
They had Link they just flip the whole game because Link is left-handed.
Right.
And the sword is used in the right hand.
Oh.
I was just referencing that.
Yeah, whatever.
It's a deep cut.
Deep cuts.
Moving
from,
on.
From like 2007, 8?
7, yeah. It's the last time I played a video game.
Oh, came Lord.
Out. Speaking of new games that are old, let's talk about Rainbow Six.
Sure. Is anybody here going to actually play Rainbow Six?
I'll watch it on Twitch. Unless it turns out to be like super cool. I mean, like the siege mode.
Like, yeah,
that's pretty cool. And the terrorist mode sounds pretty cool, but like,
yeah, exactly. Like, I don't think any of us are gonna play it.
I need to see it played
because we
on
don't
PC by normal people, not by like Ubisoft, like
yeah, game testers.
Yeah, yeah, not people just like using fake commands. I need to see how the game actually evolves. Like, it could be like Counter-Strike, where I think Counter-Strike's pretty cool. I'd never play it because I don't have the skill required.
You know what, this is a little bit of a tangent from Rainbow Six, but Ubisoft likes to do this, something that really irritates me is when they show off their multiplayer games, they like to script their dialogue.
Oh, it's so irritating.
They did this, I think they did it with this game, with Siege, and they also did it with The Division and all of the Division trailers.
Yes, they did,
oh,
yeah.
I hate
no
it.
No one talks
it's,
like that.
It's so fake. And it annoys me so much, but that's just my little tangent. So we can go back to talking about blowing up walls.
Yeah. The wall blowing up's cool.
Yeah, destruction's cool. We don't have a group of friends to play that game.
I think that destruction would be way cooler if you could blow up any wall you want to.
Yeah, but then it would be Battlefield.
No, then it would be Faction.
Okay, fair enough.
Too good.
That would be too good if Volition came back and made a Red Faction.
Yeah, Volition just shows up. They're like, we don't have a press conference, but we brought, like, Red Faction.
Yeah, we're not making Saints Row
anymore. We can't
call
it Red Faction.
No.
Because we don't own that right.
Ruby.
Iron Planet.
Okay, that's... Yeah, sure.
There we go. Iron turns red and it's oxidized.
Yeah, that's cool. That's
you don't have anything to say about it, do you?
Nope. I'm not into that kind of shooter.
Yeah,
so.
you don't really play that kind of tactical shooter.
I think I tried playing a Rainbow Six game once, and it just kind of flew all over my head.
If it's an old Rainbow Six game, those are Sims.
Are hardcore.
Yeah, those are Sims. They're not fun games. The Rainbow Six Vegas.
I played Vegas stuff. 1 and 2, and I liked it.
Oh, that's important to note. When you buy Siege, you get Vegas, and Vegas 2.
What?
For free.
What?
I think it's only on the Xbox, though.
Oh. That totally would have made me buy it if that were on PC.
I don't know. Yeah.
I like those games. I think I own them on Steam, but
buy
still.
Buy it again. Who gives a fuck?
Oh, well.
Give me the codes.
Yeah, sure. We'll play together.
Yeah, see? Yeah. I'll play Rainbow Six.
I don't think there's co-op. There wasn't co-op in Vegas.
Rainbow Six 3.
Rainbow Six 3, yeah, that's not a game for fun.
No.
Yeah. Anyway,
although the co-op stuff in those old Rainbow Six games was actually pretty good.
Yeah, but you actually had to be coordinated.
Yeah, it was for a day when you had like friends and stuff.
Yeah, back
which
way back
no
when.
Longer have. So we're gonna switch over from shooting dudes to stabbing dudes in For Honor, where you play a knight, a samurai, or
a viking. Yeah. I haven't really seen much of that game outside of that trailer.
Yeah,
I saw that there was an actual like gameplay video, but I haven't watched it.
They demoed it on stage.
Oh, see, I'd like to
mention the thing that you just talked about, Wallace, with the fake communication thing they were doing. Like,
were they doing that too?
Yeah, they were doing it in that too. Yeah.
They were also they had a multiplayer thing 4v4 or whatever, and it was like a kind of like the two developers kind of looking over what their one match or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And that also seemed like, I don't remember the last time I've heard anyone ever talk to another person like that.
It seemed really scripted.
Like, yeah, it's like, oh, you won this battle, but you're not going to win the war. It's like, you motherfucker, you're reading a script right now,
really,
aren't you?
Really bad put downs. Yeah. That's what annoys me about any Ubisoft game where they play multiplayer.
I know that they're doing that so that it's family friendly, but come on, guys.
Yeah, but it's really
hokey.
Know
your audience.
It's so hokey. And you
actually
see
Ubisoft,
right through it.
Ubisoft did some cool stuff before their press conference where they had a bunch of their devs read off the angry tweets that people send them.
For Unity? Or just in general?
Yeah, just in general.
Oh, okay.
It was pretty funny.
That sounds pretty good.
It was like well-knowing, but yeah. Oh, also, I didn't know if anyone cared about this, but I'll just slip it in here. Stick of Truth 2.
Oh, the fractured butthole.
Yes, the fractured butthole.
South Park. Oh, man.
I want to like that, but... I mean, they said they're fixing the combat, so...
They mention it in the game. Like, Cartman brings up that the first one wasn't that great, and he wants to make it better. Like, seriously,
Well, the in-world thing is they are playing a game.
Yeah.
So I assume, like in-world, he thinks that the game sucked. Probably because he lost.
Yeah, probably.
I don't remember. I watched that game,
I think,
but I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, For Honor looks okay. But we'll see what the combat is actually like. Is it Ass Creed? Is it Batman's?
Well, you guys saw the gameplay of it, so if you want to...
They didn't show what the UI was at all.
They didn't show
it was just
that?
It was just a third-person camera with no UI.
There was they were showing the parrying stuff on the multiplayer thing and stuff where you kind of go in a little bit of a showdown when you encounter another player.
Yeah.
Is that every time?
I've no idea.
I assume
like,
they
it's
put
like
you
the
into
lock
single
on.
Combat.
It's the when you go into like you lock onto a player and you can kind of like parry and stuff off based off of where they're attacking and stuff. It has like a little tell, I guess. I find the way that the one knight guy wields his fucking sword is retarded. So that kind of was immediate turn off where he fucking grabs his own blade.
Yeah.
Well, and fucking beats people with like the almost his hilt of his weapon. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing?
I've got news for you, Parker. In oldie times, they couldn't sharpen weapons very well. Also, he's wearing chainmail gauntlets. What the fuck does he care?
Yeah, but still.
I know, it could be cooler.
The thing is just like, I don't know, everyone else seems to have sharp enough swords and axes. Why can't that guy?
Because he keeps holding it with his hand. He should be holding it with his, he should be holding it at the end where he's supposed to be holding it.
See, and then it's like, the way it is, it's like a 4v4 with heroes, and then there's a bunch of little AI dudes who fight each other.
Yeah, when they first showed the gameplay of that, I thought it was just going to be like a W-Force game. Like, it was just going to be fucking, Dynasty Warriors.
Yeah, that's what it reminded me of when
that's
I first
saw
it.
That's what I thought when I first saw it, and then he got into the one-on-one combat, and I'm like, no, this isn't that.
When you're fighting normal dudes, it's basically Dynasty Warriors, because you just fucking murder everybody instantly.
Yeah.
Because it looks like everyone has, all the AI has like one HP, and you just hit them once and they die.
Yeah.
But, I was like, when I seen the cinematic trailer for it, at first I was kind of like, oh my god, is it going to be like Mountain Blade? And then I'm like, no, it's not. Doubted myself immediately because that's what I was hoping for.
No. It seems to be more like chivalry than
that's what people were saying. It's chivalry,
yeah,
which is unfortunate. Well, it's fortunate because then the Mountain Blade devs can actually make Mountain Blade fucking multiplayer, please.
Mountain Blade 2?
Yeah,
not happening. It is happening, but very slowly.
And it's got guns automatically ruined.
Yeah,
actually, it doesn't have guns.
I know, but I'm just doing the worst case scenario.
I don't know. I think they learned from Fire and Sword.
You want to hear about some worst case scenarios? Let's talk about the crew.
You can talk about the crew because you're the only one who actually played it.
I'm the only person who played the crew because I got it for free with my 970. Yay. The crew is actually pretty fucking all right. I tell you what. The only problem is that you have to grind out your parts at the top end.
Right.
So there's fucking nothing to do. And some places just don't have the right parts, so you have to drive across the whole fucking country to get one part. It gives you like 3% on your car, but you need it so that you can actually play in multiplayer, because they should just let you buy all the fucking parts.
So
anyway,
yeah.
So the crew is going off-road, there's monster trucks, there's bikes. That shit sounds cool. if I buy a 980 and it comes with a 980, I'll just play them.
It probably will.
Yeah. Ask Reed. It's in London.
It's set in London. That's what it is. That's right. Yeah, I guess I'm the only one that can talk about this one.
I bought Assassin's Creed 2 for the TF2 item.
You used to buy games when they had TF2 items with them.
Yep. I bought that one specifically for that, and I never played it. I didn't even install it.
Alright, well, Assassin's Creed Syndicate looks okay, but the problem is, every year I get suckered into playing Assassin's Creed. Because I did it with Unity, and Unity was decent except for the bugs. I've been playing through Rogue recently. Rogue's okay, but it's definitely a last gen. But my fear with Assassin's Creed Syndicate, and I think I'm going to be right on this, is they haven't changed much. They've just, by the look of it, made the world bigger. So you're just going to have to run around more to do the exact same things you were doing for like the last 5 years.
But yep. You can ride on a horse carriage.
That really just plays to my point. They just made it larger.
But you can play as a girl.
So?
You can?
You're a brother and sister duo.
Yeah.
Your brother's a scrappy young lad and your sister is a... lady who stabs people.
I think
something.
Yes. I called someone laddie today, and I felt really old.
Yeah, that's a really old person thing to say.
I couldn't be like, hey kids, get out of my way.
You're just like, get out of me way, laddie.
Basically, I just made those kids' day with my giant bomb shirt. It'd be great. They have something to say now. You can post that on Twitter. At SplitScreen. Assassin's Creed, yeah. It looks like Assassin's Creed.
Yeah, it just looks like more Assassin's Creed, really.
The problem with Assassin's Creed is it's going to run like fucking balls.
Probably. I doubt they will have fixed the problems that they had with Unity. That game is, of course, coming out in the fall, and it probably will not be done completely. As ambitious as they get with those like open world games.
I have some news. Mm-hmm. Some hot news from the presses.
Hot
news coming in.
Yeah.
Gears of War HD is coming out on Windows 10.
Yay. That's it. We're going to play that probably.
Yep. Campaign coming up.
We will do a split screen co-op of that, I am sure.
We will.
Is there a 3-player co-op of that?
No. Okay.
Maybe. But probably not.
Probably not.
Aw. That'd be fun.
Yeah. We're going to talk about all that juice.
All that juice.
We played on the hardest difficulty. Moving on. Mm. Assassin's Creed, there's a cane sword. Yeah, great.
Oh, right. Cane sword.
The last motherfucking Guardian. I said it wasn't coming out on the Monday video.
You were proven wrong.
I fucked up.
No. Actually, no. You're not. You're still not wrong.
Because it's just still another trailer. Wrong.
It's still a trailer. There is no release date. It is still technically not coming out.
They showed gameplay.
They said 2016.
They showed 5 minutes.
And also,
who knows how much more the game is left? Like, how much more have they actually done?
Also, what's with your dog thing? It seems to be wrecking the place. It looks like somebody actually tried to put that place back together at one point.
Yeah, and then your weird bird dog just
fucked it all up. Yeah,
I don't know. I'm not interested.
Yeah,
I don't want.
That's a let's play with the sound off. I think
I don't want to have to escort Bird Dog around. I played Ico. I don't want to do that again.
But it's like a teamwork where you're escorting the dog and he's keeping you alive.
No, thank you.
That's about all we had to say about that.
Yeah, fuck okay. The Last
so
Guardian.
Let's talk about Rig, which is going to fucking suck,
probably.
But looks really cool.
But like MLG
the idea.
Pro.
But it's only going to suck because it's a Morpheus game.
No, it's only going to suck because it's forced pro gaming. Pro gaming has to, like, appear out of nowhere.
Yeah, it has to be natural.
For the most part.
But also,
you can't just be like, yo, this is a pro game.
I think those first few Morpheus games that come out are going to be really bad. And this is going to get caught up in that.
I mean, the whole idea of a competitive game where you're all wearing Oculuses or Morpheuses or whatever, that sounds super cool. It's getting closer to, you know, the thing that I really want? I want to fucking Euro Truck. Sorry. I want to...
Euro Truck America.
Oh, yeah.
Can I drive to my house?
America Truck.
Can I drive to your house?
Yeah, you beep, probably... Beep in front of your house. I mean, it's not... I'm sure it's not to scale. See, we're just getting off on tangent here.
Sorry, they... on the PC Gaming Show, they just... They're showing some Euro Truck, and I love Euro Truck. Speaking of Oculus Rift, I want to play...
It's USA Truck now. Or whatever it's going to be called.
It has Peterbilt. Yeah. It's Trader Talk. Talk about Peterbilt.
Talking about Peterbilt.
I prefer a long nose. Do you like cab overs?
I don't... Sure.
That's the short nose truck. You don't like cab overs. They're dumb.
All right. Back to... Rig. Back to a different kind of rig.
Yeah. See, these are all rigs. I'm interested to see how that game actually plays, and I'm interested to see if they're going to try and push it for the, like, esportsness. It's not going to work for esports.
No, it won't.
But I think it could be cool. It'd be a cool proof concept, yeah. So MechWarrior could do it better.
It seems like a cool tech demo.
Which is all that Morpheus stuff is, until the Vive comes
like
out.
Like I said, the first few Morpheus games will just be tech demos like any other new thing. So, that, I'm sure, we didn't have this on the list, but Adrift, even though that's not coming out on Morpheus, but that's coming out on like Oculus and Vive, I guess, because it's on PC. I'm sure that game... will not really be a functional game, but it'll be a really cool proof of concept.
Yeah.
That we can have decent VR now.
Yeah, with now that people have gotten the VR shit down, like they've mostly figured out what the VR first gen VR is going to be, we can start seeing all the cool concepts come out.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for the MMO.
Yeah.
/Sign, motherfucker. All you people who think Sword Art is fucking great, pro tip, go watch /Sign. Have your mind goddamn blown. By not knowing what the fuck's going on.
Yep.
Alright, moving on to another game we don't give a fuck about. Parker, did you have anything to say about Rig? Or Oculus?
No, not really.
Or virtual reality in general?
Or VR?
No.
Alright, do you have anything to say about Shenmue?
No.
That's about how I feel about Shenmue as well.
Shenmue 3, come on, man. Get hype. Shenmue 3. No?
No.
Nah,
okay.
I think that's how I feel about Shenmue as well.
Yeah. I think we're pretty much done with that.
You know what doesn't make a lot of sense? Shenmue in a world where we have Yakuza. Because they're basically the same thing. Shenmue's just longer and less fighting.
Yeah.
And fewer hanging out with girls in bars. Yeah. I'm figuring Shenmue 3... The girl comes, your girlfriend comes back from Canada, and she just has my face. Split screen, Shenmue crossover.
Oh, man.
2017.
That game's not coming out for years, you know that.
That game has so much funding.
Yeah, that's going to get a ton of funding, and then people are going to be so disappointed by it.
Yeah. Hopefully, I hope they release it full on. They don't, early access it. That is one of those games that needs...
It needs to just be done and out.
Yeah, it needs to happen.
Yeah. You'll get the
technique scrolls. Alright, so that's how we feel about Shenmue. How about Transformers, or as the Giant Bomb chat has called it, Platsformers?
That's not a very good portmanteau.
It looks... Well, they made that before. They didn't even know it was Platinum when they made that joke. So...
Well, that still doesn't make it good.
A Transformers game made by Platinum.
It's a game made by Platinum, so...
That looks like a fucking cartoon.
It looks like the Transformers cartoon. It's made by Platinum. I'm interested in both of these. These check off on my list.
I need to know, are there rules of Cybertron nature, is what I need to know.
Maybe. I don't know.
I want to know the soundtrack. Platinum not only is good with, like,
probably heavy metal, knowing Platinum.
Yeah, it'd be perfect for the stream.
Yeah. But you transform, you punch dudes. It's probably got platinum game mechanics, so it's pretty fluid.
Which time?
Yeah, it's got something similar.
Energon time.
You beat up Decepticons. Maybe they'll let you be a Decepticon, you beat up the Autobots, who knows.
Yeah. Why not be both?
Do a little bit
Decepticons
of both.
Aren't always evil.
Mostly.
Yeah, mostly. Well, Megatron's kind of a jerk. Happens when you're a fucking pistol. Will they use old Megatron?
Yes.
Yeah, pistol Megatron
looks like
returns.
It'll be old Megatron.
Nice. Parker, do you have any feelings about this? Do you feel like they should take this and make it into a better anime game?
Nah, I don't know. I wasn't really ever into Transformers.
Yeah,
so.
Me either. That's why I want them to make it a better anime
you
game.
You think they should just make it a Gundam game instead? Did I just... Uh-oh. I can hear your desk cracking again.
I want to be Zex. my red comet.
You need to stop doing that, Wallace.
Sorry.
Which is the name of his mech, by the way.
He doesn't have a job, so he can't afford another desk.
Crack your
this
desk
is
ag- with
this
your
desk
erection.
Cost me $40.
Oh.
Pretty good desk.
Yeah, but you don't have any money right now, so it's kind of hard for you to even spend $40.
It's true. I need that money to pay my phone bill and stuff. So, Platformers looks really sweet. Transformers looks really sweet, except that it's Transformers. And hopefully they're not going to do what they did to Legend of Korra, which was make a fucking shitty game that looked pretty cool.
Yeah, because
that's what they did with Legend of Korra.
Oh.
Moving, we're now in Japan land. So let's continue in Japan land to Star Ocean. For Parker, because he's the only person who's ever played a Star Ocean game.
Yeah, Waste, bring it on me, man. I didn't even know about this until, like, an hour and a bit ago before this.
Your hype is fresh, then.
It looks alright. I mean, the combat looks interesting, considering it's no longer three people. It's, like, six or seven or whatever it was.
How'd you like those transitions on the video? That was good shit.
Yeah, where they did, like, multiple...
shots that doesn't hurt your brain at all.
No, it doesn't make you go
fucking
crazy.
Fucking really annoying is what I found it.
Yeah.
Because I don't appreciate video editing like that. It hurts.
You shouldn't, because it's bad.
Yeah, it's very clunky and distracting.
Apparently, they're going to make it seamless with no loading screens.
They
so
didn't
that's cool.
make the editing seamless.
And they're going for 60 frames, which is cool. The
probably
dev was
that.
Very fat.
It doesn't make me want to buy a PS4, but...
He was. He's wearing a golf shirt with a suit on top of it.
Like, that's an interesting thing. That's the interesting thing to point out about the video game. It's like, yeah, the dev probably shouldn't lose a few.
The dev looked like maybe he put some panties on his face and sniffed them a few times. I'll tell you what.
All right.
Also, there's a little girl with a backpack, and that's kind of cute.
Yeah, kawaii.
All right. So, we're still in Japan land. Let's go to Star Fox. Star Fox Zero.
Yeah, Star Fox.
Star Fox.
It might make me buy a Wii U.
It looks a lot like the Star Fox 2.
It doesn't look very good.
No.
Like visually.
But it's on the Wii.
Kind of bad.
Apparently it runs 60, so that's why it looks like balls.
Yeah, but it's more Star Fox. And
you know what that game also is?
Hmm?
Platinum.
Is that a Platinum game?
Platinum is helping them out with boss fights and stuff.
Oh, see? That
rules
is,
of nature,
that
motherfucker.
Tempts me even more.
It, more importantly, everyone should turn this stream, pause it, and go and watch the start of the Nintendo press conference.
You need to watch the start of the Nintendo press conference.
Because that is some fucking shit.
That is good. It is very good.
Fucking shit.
But yeah.
Also, yeah. I've never been interested in Star Fox. It was like before my gaming time. So,
well, at this point I'm looking for an excuse to buy a Wii U, and I think Star Fox might be it. Also, there's what was the other game? I'll remember it at some point. But there was one other game that's coming out on the Wii U that I just go like, I'll buy it then. I'll totally buy it then.
Yeah, totally.
I'll buy it. I'll play that game, and then I'll never touch a Wii U.
Perfect.
Just like the Wii.
All right, here's something that Parker can actually be hype about, maybe.
How do you feel about
Fire Emblem?
It looks good. It looks like they are fixing some of the issues with the last Fire Emblem game, which is the pairing system where you could just have two units travel together and get a shit ton of stat bonuses for it. And the enemies couldn't do that. Also, people have feet. Didn't have feet before. Their legs just kind of tapered off.
They had like little stilt legs, didn't they?
Yeah.
Wasn't it more kawaii beforehand?
Are
you a foot...
Do you have a foot fetish, Parker?
No, I don't really like the DS way they do fucking models, so...
Oh, you mean that, like, Final Fantasy style?
Yeah, because that's sort of what it was. So, if they can step away from that, which is adding feet is a start to that, that'd be great.
There seems combat to be, like, some sort of story. Where, like, there's, like, dark and light stuff going on.
Yeah.
And someone turns into, like... a large deer.
Deer Jesus is still a thing, so I guess.
Yeah, I don't know.
Lucha deer makes an appearance.
Shit. No, that's further down on the list, obviously.
Yeah.
It's his dad, obviously.
Father of Lucha deer.
Lucha dad.
Lucha dad. That's better. that was better. I like that one.
We're getting somewhere. Anyway. I believe I've seen some gameplay elsewhere, not in E3. And it looks alright. It's the same thing. It's the same thing every other Fire Emblem games have been.
Yeah, it's Fire Emblem.
Yeah, it looks like the first 3DS Fire Emblem, except more.
Yeah. The whole thing about Fire Emblem is you play it for, like, basically just, like, support conversations and stuff like that for the most part. Like, the tactics is still there, and it's still interesting and varied combat and stuff. But, like, the interaction between the characters is what makes Fire Emblem popular, so... It looks like it's still there, so... It's probably going to be good, because as long as you can sort of hold a pen, you'll probably make it good.
Bad news, I'm left-handed.
Well, can you at least hold an anime cliche book in your right hand?
No.
Well, then, I'm sorry. I know. So you write with your left, and then you'd have the book open with your right hand.
Oh, can you play it in vertical way?
I don't know.
Because that would be cool, actually.
It's the other one, no, but you don't need a fucking stylus or anything. It's the game's never been that
complicated. Oh, you mean it's good? Got it.
Yeah.
Wrecked.
It doesn't use Nintendo technology, basically, because it doesn't need to. It's that simple.
Well, it's a tactics game.
Yeah, there's not much you can do with it.
Except make it fucking good, because it's a tactics game. Tactics games are good.
Yep.
If only it came out on a console I gave a fuck about. I don't want to... buy a 3DS for two games.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
Actually, three games, because this next one is a doozy. Parker, do you have anything else to say about Fire Emblem?
Nope.
We don't want to cut you off. So let's go to the doozy. It's one after this one.
Yeah, the one after it's the doozy.
First, we're talking about stupid Metroid on the list.
Here,
I think it's called Metroid Hunters or something like that.
Well, let's not talk about that one just yet.
Oh, but dude...
It's on the list.
All right, fine. Okay, that's the next one. Fine. What is it? Metroid Prime Federation Force?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what it's called. What the fuck is that? Who at Nintendo thought, you know, people are really clamoring for another Metroid Prime game. We're hearing endless bitching about it. Let's make some weird co-op game for the 3DS and not listen to any of their complaints.
Let's break that down a little more. People are clamoring for a Metroid game. Fuck Metroid Prime. Give me a side-scrolling game.
They want a Metroid Prime game.
I want an original Metroid game.
I'm with you on that. I also want
a side-scrolling ass Metroid game.
I want one of
those
too.
Shoot stuff and find out she's a girl.
That is not at all Other M, because Other M was dumb.
No.
But instead, one, people want Metroid Prime because I can't understand why. But then Nintendo decides, no, we're not going to listen to you completely. So no Wii U Metroid Prime announced. Here's a 3DS game that's co-op. And then also they're like these weird chibi Metroids, or the weird chibi like space bounty space hunters. Marines. Space, they're not space marines, they're bounty hunters. Or are they space marines? Are they actually space marines? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, fine. But yeah. What is that? Come on.
You know, in Prime, the part that I found fun in Prime was scanning the space marines. I like the space marines. I like the way their armor looks. And that's about all I like about that game. That is coming up. I mean, it's a lock-on first-person shooter for the 3DS. So, like, they should have made it a Wii game, been like, hey, yo, by the way, we also do first-person shooters. I know Splatoon just came out, but here's one not for babies.
Man. Like, did they think it was a good idea? Or did they just go, well, we have to wait a little while before we make the actual Prime game? Or is this to fund the Prime game? Because Nintendo's, like, printing money still, aren't they? I know the Wii U isn't selling very well, but they
Splatoon
have a stockpile
is
of
printing
cash.
Money.
Yeah. So, why would you make that decision? Why? Why would you greenlight this little fucking 3DS game?
I mean, if it just came out and it was just like a game, like, here you go.
Yeah, but they put it in their press conference.
Yeah,
and they went like,
in their
here's
video.
A new awesome game. No, that's not what anybody wanted.
And then it's got that ball multiplayer mode, which is weird. You know, the ball multiplayer mode is actually, like, probably the best part of that game.
Probably. It will probably be the only entertaining part of that game.
You know what might be really cool is if that's all multiplayer co-op online.
That I think it is.
So if it's that, then it's cool, but I don't think anybody's going to want to play it.
No, that's my point.
I mean, you already have Monster Hunter. Problem solved. Yeah. You don't need any more co-op games ever. Except more Monster Hunter. Because that's what the people
want.
I'm
just shaking my head right now.
Let's talk about a game with four players who may not be players.
I only saw three. That trailer only has three.
It only has three at a time.
Really?
But it showed both normal Luigi
and Paper
Luigi.
Normal
Mario, Paper Luigi, Paper Mario.
Well, then why are there only three of them?
Mario, Paper.
Paper Jam? Yeah.
Paper Jam.
Is it just Mario Paper Jam, or is it Mario
and
Luigi?
It's Mario and Luigi, because it's a Mario and Luigi RPG game.
It's one of those
3DS... Like the Bowser's Inside Story?
Yeah, it's one of those, the handheld Mario and Luigi games, except this one's also on 3DS?
I believe it's also on 3DS. Okay. This game is using, by the looks of it, using the Super Mario RPG graphics for Mario and Luigi, the original, one of the Mario and Luigis, and then the other one is all paper.
Yeah. So they basically crossed the Mario RPG with Paper Mario.
Yeah, so you can have a larger party and paper
you
stuff.
Have three people now, at least from what the trailer shows.
Papercraft Mario.
Yeah, papercraft hammers. You hit people. Solve puzzle. It looks to be like the same as all the other.
Yeah, it's another Mario RPG. Yeah. So if you like that sort of stuff, then
it's not a true Paper Mario sequel.
Yeah,
so
if it was more
care.
Paper Mario.
If it were another like big Paper Mario, and if that were coming out for Wii U, if they had announced an actual Paper Mario for Wii U, I would have ordered one today.
Yeah.
Because I'd be like, I want some Paper Mario. Yeah,
Paper Mario. Man. I feel like they could have replaced Paper Mario with Wario and Wario-related things.
Paper Wario
would
have been fine,
the same
too.
Thing. Not even Paper Wario, just regular Wario.
No. Paper Wario, and like each letter of Mario is on a different piece of paper, and it shows like a Paper Mario, like everything's all great trailer, and then right at the end, you hear, and Wario comes out, flips the M around.
Okay.
Yeah. And then leaves.
It would have Waluigi in it as well.
Luigi.
I'd be alright with that. If they made another WarioWare game.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Paper Wario is actually all WarioWare minigames, but an RPG.
Paper Wario.
So all your attacks, like all the timing attacks are just WarioWare games.
Oh, Paper Wario would be good.
See, they fucked up.
Fucked up, Nintendo.
My body's ready to work at Nintendo.
Yeah, where's my paycheck?
Yeah, I'll go to Japan. I don't give a fuck.
Anyway, talking about making games for Nintendo.
Super Mario Maker is fucked up. If you watch that stream, with Cosmo and that other guy who I think is a YouTuber or some dumb shit.
Maybe.
That game, like, what you can do in that game is, that's some fucked up shit.
Yeah.
But that, it looks really, really cool. It looks like you could have, like, Splunky challenge levels and stuff in that, which sounds really cool. Challenge Reggie should be a, like, weekly thing.
Whoever can take down Reggie,
yep,
gets his position at Nintendo.
Gets his friend pass.
Gets his physique, so he looks like the Hulk.
Turns out you just turn into a Muppet.
Muppet Reggie is freakishly weird. Like, his like upper torso is like...
Well, he's one of the Muppets where the guy's putting his hand through the Muppet.
Yeah.
And he has full hand control. So he's like super top heavy.
Muppet Miyamoto looks exactly like Miyamoto. I don't know how they did that.
Muppeteering.
Muppeteering.
They turned him into a Muppet. Kermit the Frog was actually a person.
Oh, man.
It ain't easy being green, I tell you what.
No, it ain't easy.
How do you feel about Mario Maker, Parker?
I'm not a Mario man, so...
What if it was Pokemon Maker?
Still eh, because there's already tools for that.
It's true. They're putting it as like, hey, you wanna like make Mario levels with your kids and stuff?
Not really.
Not really.
How do you feel about original Mario? Do you like that one?
I just make like one block and then the rest of it's just fire?
Can I make like a Dark Souls level?
And then just be like, this is the tribulations of life, child. You need to get used to the fact that it's unfair.
Yeah. And there's like a Karibo shoe just out of reach.
There's just a hammer bro tossing hammers at you. You have to constantly jump.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some dark shit. Speaking of dark shit, remember Final Fantasy VII last year?
Yeah.
Know what they did this year? They actually fucking released the thing they were supposed to last year.
Kept up with their promise, apparently.
Last year they were like, oh, we're going to re-release the PC version for your PS4 and it's going to be upscaled. And everybody was like, oh, that fucking sucks. Why would you do that? And then Square came back. They went to Japan and like that guy fucking killed himself because he was so disappointed. He lit the entire country down. And then this year, they were like, oh, maybe we should just make Final Fantasy VII again. With each so that's what they're doing.
Yeah.
Yay.
Except there's no indication when it's coming out.
Yeah, or gameplay of any kind.
Or any gameplay at
all. But if you look at Final Fantasy XV, which fucking looks amazing.
Yeah, it does.
They could totally pull off what's in that trailer, almost.
Oh, well, sure they could. It's just when at this point.
How many Blu-rays does it come on? Four?
Blu-rays.
It's gonna need four
physical
Blu-rays.
Media.
You're not gonna want to download 240 gigs worth of Final Fantasy, I assure you. But let us embrace whatever it brings. I assure you, son.
I assure you of this.
Not on your internet, that's for sure.
No, not on my internet. That would take weeks.
So Final Fantasy got the internet all fucking wet.
Yeah, big deal.
You know what gets me wet?
You want to... Actually, I don't know if you want to do this one yet. Do we want to talk about the other thing?
Oh, Final Fantasy trash?
Final Fantasy what the fuck?
All these Final Fantasy games, like...
What's with all this Final Fantasy trash?
You know what I forgot to put on this list?
Something.
Another piece of trash.
What?
The Kingdom Hearts.
Oh.
Final Fantasy trash, which just goes into Final Fantasy trash. This is all like... mobile game bullshit.
Yeah, all the mobile stuff
that no one cares about,
man. So they that world of Final Fantasy, they transform from being really cute to being not as cute, and then they can ride on top of each other and vice versa.
Yeah, it's about stacking.
Oh, hooray.
Yay. And you get different combos based on who's stacked on top of who.
Oh, great.
Yay. And then there's a Kingdom Hearts game that happens before Kingdom Hearts, apparently.
Okay.
And it's a phone game, so no one gives a fuck.
Yeah. Do we want to talk about Kingdom Hearts 3 for a minute?
We should talk about probably Kingdom Hearts 3. Kingdom Hearts 3 is a game.
It's a game, and it's coming out at some point.
It looks really good.
I don't know, because they showed one piece of it.
It looks really good.
Okay.
I just want to hear that song.
If you say so, man.
I just want to hear her coming.
You only saw one level.
See, motherfucker.
Subarashi. No, really, that's how the Japanese song goes.
No, I'm
it's
sure.
Fucking awesome.
All right, that's fine. I'll give you that. Maybe that'll be in the new one.
I really would want a dual language version of that game. That'd be fucking great.
Yeah, it'll probably happen.
Yeah, Kingdom Hearts happened. The world is so wet from Final Fantasy and Kingdom Hearts happening in the same event. Let's talk about a way to shield your eyes from the wetness.
When
in Deus Ex,
you put
by
sunglasses. Well, you put sunglasses in your face.
Yeah, that. I assume they automatically go off.
Yes.
Or maybe it's like he thinks them on.
I think he might have like some muscle twitch that puts them out. I think
that sounds like the coolest thing ever. Really.
Yeah. This isn't a social call. So yeah, sunglasses in your face in Deus Ex.
They really should make. In fact, I should not. I should just make the trailer. That is just sunglasses at night. It's just him walking around at night.
Yeah, you should do that.
Just turning his sunglasses.
That'll be
on
a nice side project.
Yep. That game, you get a shield. There are mech people who are not cool with, or the normal people don't like the mech people because they're terrorists.
Yeah. Well, they might not be deemed as terrorists.
Yeah. That game.
As the woman in the press conference says, it's a. Something apartheid.
That's the word.
Oh, it was apartheid. The thing.
What the fuck does that even mean?
It means segregation. Like.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's.
Why not just say segregated?
It was a time in South Africa where the white South Africans and the black South Africans were completely segregated.
So is this game happening in South Africa?
No, well, I think.
I mean, it could.
I mean, it's just all she basically meant was that the augmented people were being segregated and put into ghettos, and all the people who were not augmented are all better off.
Except for you, because you're a badass.
Well, yeah, because you got sunglasses in your face.
Yeah. See, they should have got that augment. That game looks pretty good.
That game looks like more Deus Ex. So if you played Human Revolution, you'll probably like that game.
You know,
should we start calling it Deus Ex? Because that'd be funny.
Deus Ex.
That's been done for too many years, I think.
Deus Ex. Yeah. Deus Ex? Maybe.
You know, it is also a game that looks a lot like another game. Just Cause 3.
Just Cause 3.
Do we want? Just Cause 3.
Yeah, Just Cause 3.
It's not on the list.
It's not on the list.
I'm going to put it on the list right now because it's important.
Oh man, we're ad-libbing now. That's not good.
Have you guys actually seen the trailer?
Nope.
I have.
Okay, that's all that matters because Parker doesn't.
Yeah, because Parker doesn't. I know you don't give a shit about.
There's no TF2 items. I'm sorry.
God, it's the worst.
I'm going to play it.
You get a wingsuit.
I absolutely am going to play that game.
Please let me have this co-op experience with.
They didn't say it was going to be co-op.
They didn't, but they have the multiplayer shit set up from the last game. You think they'd just keep going with that?
I would hope so, but they didn't announce it. They didn't say, like, hey, there's co-op. So, you never know.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I hope. I can only hope.
You get a wingsuit. You can grapple stuff.
Infinite grenades.
You get to actually...
Multiple grapples.
You get to reel in your grapple now. So you can pull shit to other shit, and then...
I was listening to one Jeff Gerstmann.
Oh,
on the trail.
GiantBomb.com?
Of GiantBomb.com. A website that I may or may not have stolen our Monday video idea from.
Maybe. Just a little
maybe.
Bit.
Yeah. He was saying they showed him that with attaching one end of the grapple to a statue hand and the other hand to a statue face and then reeling them
face
together.
Palm?
Face palm.
Face palm. Oh.
Which sounds really fucking awesome.
Oh, so good. That sounds so good.
Awesome.
I'm totally gonna get that game.
It's more cars, more stuff. You're going back to the land of your mother, so they probably have a ridiculous accent there as well.
I think it's some Mediterranean.
I kind of wish that they were just like bad Spanish. They need to mix Mexican and like Northern European together. That would be a good one.
I think that's pretty much like Portugal.
I don't
not to offend any Portuguese. But anyway.
Write in if you're a Portuguese.
Yeah, if you're a Portuguese listener, I'm sorry.
I don't know how to say anything in your language.
Lo siento? Maybe not Spanish.
Eh.
Which I'll probably offend you doubly for speaking Spanish. Anyway.
Anyway, let's get to what matters here.
Yeah.
A game I think we can all enjoy. A game with style. A game with personas.
A game.
The fifth persona.
Hopefully.
Are you a prisoner, Wallace?
It depends on a prisoner of what.
Do you demand shit, I forgot what that word was.
Emancipation?
There you go.
Oh.
Do you demand that?
Yes. Sure.
Do you have a sweet cat friend who transforms?
In my mind, yes.
Do you hang out at the bar that happens to look a lot like the Catherine
bar? That bar in Catherine, yes.
Yeah. Is the Catherine guy there looking at dirty pictures on his phone?
Probably.
I hope so.
I would hope
so. I should really beat that game one day.
No.
But that trailer has motherfucking style.
Yeah, I mean, the trailer that they sent out is basically the trailer that they sent out before, but it's in English.
Yeah, it's just a little longer.
Oh, is it a little long? No.
The end part where he transforms was not
in
the trailer.
Oh, right, there's like an extra 5 seconds.
Yeah, where he is like, yo, I'm inside the TV, fool. But I don't think that's actually what it is. But no, he has like the inside of the TV eyes.
Yeah. But anyway, Persona 5.
Persona 5, I don't know what to say about it. It's going to be more Persona. It's going to be stylish.
But it's going to be a different Persona. It's going to there are going to be platforming bits.
There's weird platforming
stealthy
stuff.
Bits. Hopefully.
And there's lots of enemies on the screen there.
Yeah,
so I don't know, like, is it an action game or is that just a point with a lot of enemies on the screen that you run into?
I think it's enemies you run into that you go into battle phase. Because there is still a battle phase. So it's probably going to be the same old mechanic, but it looks really cool.
That game is like 1,000,000% Japanese, and it's better for it.
But it shouldn't be anything other than that.
Hey, remember when Japan had fucking style? By the way, it still does.
It's called Persona.
It's called Persona and Platinum.
Yeah.
Get on our level, Americans. Figure your shit out. You ever notice... You notice that a lot of the games on the stage this E3 are presented by Swedish people or Northern Europeans?
Presented by foreign people.
Yeah.
People with accents that are not American.
People who have access to good schools.
Yeah.
And don't mind living in the middle of fucking nowhere.
Who are educated.
Edumacation? We don't do that here on Trailer Talk.
Nope.
We don't demand no pantations. I think that's about it for right now.
Yeah.
Yep.
I should make a note.
That's going to be our E3 wrap-up, I think.
That's our E3 wrap-up, at least for now. Maybe there'll be another one next week where we get all the stuff that we missed.
I'm sure there will be more trailers that at least we can talk about.
Yeah.
And I'm sure our next episode will be shorter than this.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. Although, we'll see.
Yeah, maybe.
We'll see. Maybe we'll talk about things... other than just trailers.
Oh my god.
Maybe this will just turn into a podcast.
I think it might.
About American Truck Simulator.
Because I kind of liked this.
It's pretty good.
This was pretty good.
See, we need like faces or some shit.
I know.
Maybe we'll draw faces. Maybe you guys can buy cameras, you fucking idiot.
No.
Okay.
Dude, I have way too many things I have to buy first before camera.
Anyway, so this, I'm going to close it up. Normally here, if we're going to turn this into a podcast, this would be where you, like, ask us questions and shit. We'll answer pretty much anything. So, just shoot me an email at emailsplitscreen@gmail.com is our email address. We'll eventually start doing this live as well, so this will be recorded probably on a Tuesday. Or something, I don't know yet. Tuesday seems alright though. Thanks for hanging out. I'm Civvie.
I'm Parker.
And I'm Wallace.
Hope you have a nice night. Or day. This is being posted in the morning. So hope you have a nice day. E3 day 2 is happening right now for you guys, or it's in the future, so day whatever, I suggest you watch our stuff, check out our playlists, watch our Monday video. Wallace has something to say for himself right now, speaking of our Monday video.
Do I? Oh, right. There is going to be a correction. No murdered soul suspect anymore at all, ever. Because fuck that game.
You almost were murdered by boredom.
That game nearly killed me out of boredom. So it's actually going to be more Akiba's trip. Even though technically the episode is going to go up on Saturday, it is about a half hour ahead of where the quick look ended because... fucking OBS ate the first episode.
Can I just leave?
Yeah. But anyway, yeah. So no more Murdered Soul Suspect. Fuck that game.
Fuck that game.
Mic drop.
And fuck you guys.